I feel obligated to confront the remarkable quantity of racist remarks throughout YouTube videos, especially in written comments. They leave the impression that everything that matters is filtered through ideas about skin color. That's not just sad, it's simply uninformed. Genetic research has proved that every human being on the face of this earth descended from one of no more than 40 extended family groups in West Africa. No more than about 2,000 people, and some say as few as 1,000, survived a natural catastrophe that nearly drove human beings to extinction. The fact is that black is nature's favorite skin color. Even polar bears are black as coal, not white. The same proves true of humans. Andrea Manica at Cambridge University compared over 6,000 skulls from more than 100 ancient human populations. He measured 37 male and female DNA patterns and proved that all peoples descended from African ancestors. That means we are all what we choose to call Negroes. That seems confusing because as we look at what we call the races of man, we naturally ask, how could it be possible that children of so many colors all descended from parents of only one color? There is an answer. In 2000, anthropologist Nina G. Jablonski at California Academy of Sciences discovered a high correlation between skin color and average annual ultraviolet radiation at various distances from the equator. Everybody in the world originally migrated from Africa generally, and from very near the equator specifically. That is why their ancestors had black skin. But depending upon where their descendants migrated, skin changed color over time. Eventually, some descendants moved so far from the equator that their skin turned white. This is not guesswork. Correlations between ultraviolet radiation and skin color are so precise that skin color can be predicted mathematically, as shown. There must be an explanation for this correlation between ultraviolet light and skin color, and the explanation proves to be genetic. In 2005, a team at Penn State University discovered one of the genes that determines skin color, which is properly called pigmentation. They named it SLC24α5 and studied it in zebrafish. Zebrafish were chosen because of various genetic similarities to humans. They also have similar pigment cells, which, as in humans, contain granules called melanosomes. Figure A shows a zebrafish with black pigmentation in its scales. In comparison, Figure B shows change in pigmentation when gene SLC24α5 is mutated in zebrafish DNA. Pigmentation becomes lighter. This parallels what we see in Caucasian humans. This gene is responsible for the amount of melanin released into the skin. Therefore, SLC24α5 allows us to become more black in response to ultraviolet light. The farther we move from the equator, the whiter we become over time. That distance from the equator determines skin color and means that we all walk a potentially deadly solar tightrope. If we lose our balance in either direction, we will die because sunlight gives us vitamin D as well as ultraviolet light. If we live close to the equator, our melanin gives us a really great suntan, but it also reduces absorption of vitamin D. On the other hand, if we live far from the equator, we absorb enough vitamin D because our reduced melanin means that we don't get good suntans. But then, we just end up dying of skin cancer. This map illustrates distribution of indigenous peoples and skin colors that make the best trade-offs between too much ultraviolet light and too little vitamin D. People with black skin live within the dark blue areas near the equator. People with brown skin
live within the light blue areas. Black lines bordering the light blue shaded areas represent the Tropic of Cancer in the Northern Hemisphere and the Tropic of Capricorn in the Southern Hemisphere. Above and below these black markers, indigenous peoples are Caucasian.
We asked how it is possible that children of so many colors came from parents of only one color. The answer is that nature does all that it can to keep us alive, strong, and healthy. Man is the only creature on Earth that lives and thrives in every ecology except underwater and at the South Pole. We can do that only because we have evolved as the world's most accomplished adapters to local conditions. One ability to adapt is the ability to change skin color in response to varying amounts of sunlight, so that the source of our life does not become the cause of our death.